Hello students, the question here is a pea plant homozygous for axial flowers and constricted pods is crossed with a pea plant homozygous for terminal flowers having inflated pods. Work out the cross up to the F1 generation and also show the genotypes of the parents and the phenotype of the progeny. So this is the question. We have to solve this, right? So let us first find out what is given in the question. And the first thing that is given is about the parents. So here the parents are going to be having, let's say, the one with axial flowers with constricted pod, and this is being crossed with terminal flower with inflated pod. And when we talk about this, you have to understand that the axial position of the flower is a dominant trait. So here we will go with capital A genotype for the axial position. So for terminal we'll go with small a. Now constricted pod and inflated pod. So here the inflated pod is a dominant one, so here we'll go with capital I, and here for constricted we'll go with small i. So here is our genotype for the parents. Now from here you have to find the gametes, which are simple, straightforward. So here we are going to have one type, that is capital A small I, and here small a capital I. So these are the gametes of these parents respectively. Now coming to the progeny, so the progeny here, or the F1 generation here, it is simply a combination of these two. They both will fuse together and they'll give us the progeny, and the progeny here is going to be capital A small a capital I small I, and that is a heterozygous condition where we are going to have a phenotypic expression as axial position of the flower and inflated pods. Now question they're asking is, we have worked out the cross up to F1 generation, that is check, we have done it. Now they're asking the genotype of the parents. We have done that also, genotype of the parents. Anyway, when you write in the examination, you have to write genotype of the parents is going to be capital A capital A small I small I and small a capital I capital A respectively for these two parents they're asking, and the phenotype of the progeny. So progeny phenotype we have already written, that is going to be your axial and inflated axial flower with inflated pods, and the genotype here is going to be capital A small a capital I small I. So that's basically what you have to do in this particular question. The question is, with the help of a Punnett square, find the percentage of heterozygous individuals in F2 population in a cross involving a true breeding pea plant with green pods and a true breeding pea plant with yellow pods respectively. So here both the plants are true breeding, that is we are going to talk about a homozygous plant for this particular trait, and we're going to cross them, and we have to find out the percentage of heterozygous individuals in the F2 population. So we have to make the cross all the way up to F2 generation. So start with the always with the parents. So the parents here, we have to talk about the plants with green pod, and we have to cross them with plant with yellow pod. So the green pod we will go with capital G because they are the dominant, and yellow pod with small g. Now the gametes here, right? So gametes here are going to be capital G, and here it is going to be small g. Now the F1 progeny or F1 generation, we are going to have these two gametes come together and form capital G small g. This is our hetero zygous hybrid, and the phenotype here is going to be the green pod. So as we know, here we have to go for selfing of these F1 progeny. So selfing, here you have to go with capital G small g cross with capital G small g. Now of course one is going to act as a male and one is going to act as a female plant here. So here when we go for selfing, here it is again going to be having a green pod. Both of them are going to have the green pod because of the law of dominance, and here the gametes are going to be capital G small g, capital G and small g. Now from here we have to go for the F2 generation or F2 progeny, and to find out the F2 generation or F2 progeny, we have to go for the Punnett square. So to make the Punnett square, you have to make the table, and let's do that. Here we have, okay, let's do it. Yeah, so here these gametes will replace, so capital G small g, capital capital G small g from both of these parents. So accordingly, let me change the color. Accordingly, the genotypes here is going to be capital G capital G capital G small g in this case. Now here is going to be capital G small g, and finally small g small g. So the phenotypes here are going to be the green pod. Here also you're going to have the green pod, here also you're going to have the green pod, and here we're going to have the yellow pod. Now from here what you have to find is, you have to find out the heterozygous individuals percentage. So to do that in an easy manner, we can write about the genotypic ratio, and from there we can calculate the percentage. So genotypic ratio here is going to be for the capital G and capital G small g, and we are going to have the small g small g. So 1:2:1. So here out of 4 progeny, 2 are going to be heterozygous. So here the percentage of heterozygous individuals is going to be 50%, and that's the answer.